occasionally you might even have to battle somebody. Somebody they might get tonight.
Oh, yeah.
They might have to battle somebody, you know what I'm saying? So that'll come up. You know what I mean?
There
so
he is.
You know.
Josh.
Some rotation off one of these? Or
yeah.
Which one we can pop open?
Do this one right here.
It's your birthday.
The lady one right here.
For hearts and minds.
For sure.
Any more?
You want to shop?
No.
That's the sound of the police. That's the sound of the beast. That's the sound of the police. That's the sound of the beast.
That's the sound of the police. That's the sound of the beast. Sound of the police. That's the sound of the beast. That's the sound of the police. That's the sound of a beast. That's the sound of the police.
You know what I'm gonna do?
That's the sound of a beast.
I just came from having some curry goat at the Jamaican restaurant. So I'm feeling this KRS-One roster Rage link right here. You feel me?
Bring out.
We got Chauncey Francois in the house. I gotta give a shout out to my homeboy Jason Frank, who made this beat. When I started making beats, he was the cat that I started making beats with.
That's what's up.
And he went out and bought an MPC 4000. And we were living together, and oh my God, that's all.
Changed
they were like Clinton on a spaceship.
The fact that you just said MPC is just like, wow.
Yeah, right.
Yes, I know. And they don't really use those that like they used to anymore. I mean, I can't say they, like some do, some don't, but.
Listen.
The machines.
Listen, real beat makers.
Yeah.
They still got them.
Oh my God.
You know what
and
I mean?
That I jumped, I had a Boss DR770. Little piece of shit drum machine, cost $300. And we jumped from that to an MPC 4000. Not the 1000, not the 2000.
Y'all lost y'all fucking mind.
Woo.
It was like y'all went from the prom
woo, woo.
And the after party was at the Playboy Mansion.
Play some beats,
we freestyle, you know, we get blowed, we get drunk, then we sober up, we go for a couple of sodas in the crowd,
right,
man. We
right.
just do it all, man.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
We bounce from something spiritual to, you know what I'm saying, next minute we fighting and you know, somebody's coming over, they got guns, and we try to learn how to clean them.
Right. It was Highland Park, man. You know, it was a proving ground, you know what I'm saying?
Right, really, literally.
Yeah, those are days, man.
Yeah, man.
So unpersonal.
Yeah.
So back then it was real personal. We'd get together and kick it like, it was like we'd get together and just play beats, and it wasn't even about like, yo, let's make a song. It was like, listen, let's flow, let's,
you know, let's rhyme, yeah.
Yeah, it was.
And let's get it in.
Right.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It is like a lot different now. Like you.
That was the bonding process. As a matter of fact, if the cypher wasn't the starting point, like literally, like you wake up, you know what I'm saying, you smoke a blunt. If you were smoking weed, most of us did smoke weed.
Right.
But, you know what I'm saying, you wake up, you know what I'm saying, to that, you know what I'm saying, and you had a cypher, and at the end of the day, say, like, I had to go to school, you had to go to work. It's like, hey, yo, let's do a cypher real quick before you leave.
Like, you had to get it in. It was like,
right, dude, I got something, I just want to get out.
Right, right.
I'll be sitting there mowing the lawn doing that.
It was a ritual. it was literally like our ritual.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It was like our ritual, you know?
Yeah. Right.
Mm-hmm. Marv, One, Soup, everybody, mm-hmm. The whole family was there. That was around the time 9/11 jumped off. I was on some whole other shit.
Right.
Hey. Well,
I was nervous. I was scared to go anywhere. You know what I'm saying? So I stayed close to the crib.
Because I'll touch on it. Because like at that time, it was like, you know, it was dangerous to have an Islamic name. You couldn't be Ali. You couldn't be Sharif. It was the eye of scrutiny was so focused on everything Islamic at that time.
Yeah.
That a lot of cats, like, you know,
was that shortly?
I just stayed at the crib and not get accused of shit. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Like, do you remember what time period? What year was that? Do you have Bailey's?
Yeah.
There's like three thoughts in that one sentence.
Like, what? We talk about Islam. It's Uzo, not Bailey's.
Oh, is it Uzo?
No.
Oh, shit.
If it was Uzo, I wouldn't be fucking sitting on the street.
Right. See, the people listening need to know that there is literally a fully stocked bar sitting in this studio right now. Yeah.
Man, go look at the refrigerator and the freezer.
Your opponent that you knew,
right,
because of a certain beef,
right?
You know what I'm saying? A certain, you know, situation that was going down between y'all, and like John C and journalists can contest. Back in them days, it was like if you and the artist had a beef, and we was at a, like a live show or something,
yeah, right.
They would stop the show,
right?
And let y'all settle the battle.
Since this is the kind of show that we can just like off of the top, since we talking about off of the top, yeah. Famous Dreadnought story. So yo, famous Dreadnought's in the building. We got Lush Lounge.
Yeah.
Superman. Yeah. I can talk about this shit. Superman's my man. And you know this,
right? Right? Oh,
listen. Listen. So as I'm saying, as all of that jumped off, whoever the fuck got touched, right? Because Strike was on stage, my man was on stage with Soup and Gilly, and the rest of the Dreadnoughts, right? And all I see is Soup little ass come out just doing the Hogan shit, like he just flexed somebody on their neck.
What you gonna do?
I said, God damn, I said, I'm glad this nigga my friend.
I feel like he's gonna have Hulk Hogan fall out of his
pocket. Because Super beat your ass. Right. You know what I'm saying? I mean, he's older now. I mean, you know, but you know, back then it was like, it was you never know what you was liable to see. And it was like they was going on to perform, next thing you know, just we'll see. Right.
Children, please be quiet, children, and listen to what I have to say.
1-2 nigga, 1-2 nigga, yeah nigga, mic check nigga, Suave click in the motherfucking house, ain't about a fat man.
See, it was like they was going on to perform, next thing you know, just,
a lot of shit then was so off the cusp. It's like now everybody's so careful because you got this internet, right? Oh, and God. Internet is like a window into your shit. I mean, it's just like everything else. It's a tool, you know what I mean? You can use it, you can overuse it, you can underuse it, throw it in the engine and fuck your whole shit up. You know what I'm saying? But it's a tool, you know. But it's like, but a lot of people that's on the internet are fucking tools. You know what I'm saying? So you know what I mean? But back then it was a lot different because it was like we knew all we had was us.
You would get in the battle, like you probably had like bars for a particular artist that you might think you might go up against.
Right.
And then the artist that you go up against, when they draw your name out the hat or when they scrap you in, you ain't even got bars for that person to get murdered.
You're like, oh shit, I don't even know this guy.
But right, you know. You be like, yeah, ooh, I can't wait because such and such going to be on my... And
you like, man, hold on, man. Then it'd be like, you know, Christmas put... Pulling for Christmas good. Hey, Soup, I want to battle this motherfucker. Man, I want to trade me motherfuckers to battle. I got bars for that motherfucker you picked. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, it's crazy. Wow. And then, it was just, you know, like, a lot of us was just going off the head with it. It's like you was just cutting into what a person had on. You know?
Yeah.
I
mean, yeah.
It was crazy to me. But, like, when I first started peeping, like, how they started doing it. Now, it's dope, too, but...
It changed a lot. It's different how, like, you know, like, you know, like, M had premeditated rhymes. Like, you know, we had the dreadlock incense-smelling cats at the shop. So we knew, when M was battling one of them, he was gonna say, you know, go back and tell the gods you got beat by the devil. Right. That shit is hilarious.
I mean, it was just it was
shock value.
Yeah, but it wasn't like he was like, yeah, I know you're mad because your dog died and got hit by a car when you were five. It ain't right, like he went right. down somebody.
Yeah,
you feel me? Like, they got all motherfuckers Twitter and Twitter feed and they, right, the internet right. feed and. You know, catch me like, yo, listen, I heard you call my mom's.
If we had
trying to find some shit out, I'd be like, it's not a bad.
If we had Twitter and Facebook and shit like that back then, we'd be it, this shit would be like Star Wars
in the '90s, bro. Man.
Right? I swear to God.
Nah, we couldn't have
that shit, bro. We would have been fucking.
Now, you know what? Hated. I tell you one thing though, we
animals.
We everybody would have known who the freaks was instead of just like four or five of us. Wow. Back then, everybody would have known. Back then,
you ain't lying. Like if somebody was on a down low, he would have been immediately outcasted.
Pulling this out, this is like a new little segment thing that I'm doing on the show.
Okay, see.
We got our homie in Serbia. Mm-hmm. His name is Vlada Stojanovic.
Vladdy, what's up, Vladdy, baby?
And so we decided to do this little segment where we play like a track of like an unheard of. That's, you know, dope as fuck.
Legacy listening session.
Yeah, listen. Legacy listening session. Detainment Radio. Turn it on. Louder, louder. It's time for Legacy listening session. Detainment Radio with Vlada Stojanovic.
Got inside, he's climbed through the fence and has fallen about 3 metres into the enclosure. Debate now turning to whether or not the zoo authorities did the right thing in ordering a gorilla to be shot rather than tranquilised.
I don't quite see why they felt it was a life-threatening situation.
They trying to take me out like a Harambe. I take a tranquilizer on a Monday. Why the real ones we lost get listed in the back? Why the funny motherfuckers get the front page? The world is a zoo. You've seen the news. You've seen them shoot at the youth.
The world is a zoo.
I see you pigs at the barbecue. God bless the red, white, and blue.
Harambe.
Paranoid just to hit the corner store to get a cherry cola and a bag of chips. What a bitch, they got neighborhood watch for the gangs and the cops. I ain't talking about Sanders, feel the burner on your neck. Won't give you an attorney or a gurney to get checked. We'll be lucky just to get the dirty, dying early death. They might give me 25 to life for murdering my set. Broke boys everywhere like the government in debt. Welcome to the jungle with more guns than roses. Keep them going under, now don't push me over. Hold my composure for whiskey sodas. I need that Irish, no luck with clovers.
They tryna take me out like Harambe. I take a tranquilizer on a Monday. Why the real ones we lost get listed in the back? Why the funny motherfuckers get the front page? The world is a zoo. You've seen the news. You've seen them shoot at the youth.
The world is a zoo.
I see you pigs at the barbecue. God bless the red, white, and blue.
Harambe.
Who the fuck the plug where the medicine man stay? It's only 2 o'clock and already your bad day. Need two bad bitches delivered to man cave. One man's soul is something you can't take. Call a repo man. I'm a people man. But the world don't treat you like a nickel man. I don't care if you're CEO or pizza man. We just want a piece of mind and know the piece of land.
Just breathe.
I don't want my future daughter asking why they do them like that.
Why do you do that, daddy?
Fuck, I'ma say, well, baby, the world gone mad. Losing all the heroes like the Marlboro man. Smoked all the leaves off the olive branch. How you stop a killer when the killer in the mirror and gorilla like someone come and get your little mans? Harambe.
Woo! Hey!
They tryna take me out like Harambe.
I was published as a rapper.
Okay, okay.
I was published as a poet in 1995.
Okay, so you're a little bit more sympathetic towards it. Okay.
Yeah, and then too, it's still putting words together because I write songs too. You feel me?
So. I understand that. So now everybody's going to be doing the cannabis. Like, but get these rhymes in this notebook.
They said get doing the cannabis.
No, they get these rhymes in these notebooks.
No, we don't need nobody doing the cannabis. Cannabis got smashed by L. Okay. Let's
not wait. Which?
We're not talking about the L. We're not going. We're talking right. about when he was battling disaster.
And he had
he pulled the notebook out of his. Listen to this.
Listen to this. Okay. Now I know some poets, you know, because my wife is a poet. Okay. Now they are allowed to kick their poetry off of the head, some stuff that they know.
Right.
Or they some of them have poetry books and they are able to come and stand up in front of the crowd and open their poetry books up.
And it's acceptable.
And it's acceptable.
Right.
This is fucking hip hop.
What?
I don't want to hear. I don't want to hear your notebook.
So you.
I don't want to hear your fucking tablet.
You don't want to.
That's actually that's what journalists was talking about in the beginning. You just walk over someone on the street
rocking
and get
the show. You saying you don't want to see nobody rocking the show out the phone? Now he's saying rock a show out the phone.
John C,
you feel me?
John C. Come on, man. Be for real.
I am being from
this meth. This is fucking
meth.
This is hip-hop.
Meth
cook. Method Man cannot
get
a dick. Listen, okay, it may be so, but he lose points for reading out the fucking phone.
That's
I'm
what's
serious.
Up. If that's your judge's scale, takes, that's what's
he
up.
Takes,
I
he takes the anchor way to the fucking abyss for reading off his fucking phone
so, I mean, you know,
rapping.
It takes the magic out of it.
Yeah.
No.
Right. That's what happens in the studio, though. We don't want to see the studio shit.
Johnsy, if we did a record and you can't
listen to it. Don't get me wrong. If they did that on a stage, yeah, I'd have held them to
that. That's what it is. It's on stage.
It is a stage.
It's on the radio.
On that channel.
Not just
on the radio.
Show.
It's that. Cause
I
for
love
you to
Method
freestyle.
Man.
That means off of the dome.
Method Man
I
is
can
my,
see that.
Listen, Method Man is my, yo, I love Meth. Meth is one of the
I
dudes
love him too.
Right.
In my arsenal of hip hop, just
definitely,
overlords.
Yeah.
Right.
You know
yeah,
what I'm saying?
Sure.
For real, he sweet as hell.
Yeah.
I would tell him that. I'd walk into him like, yo,
yes.
Meth. I'd be like, look, Meth, what's up? My name's Supa Emcee. I'm from Detroit. Either you know me or you don't. Hey, all
right,
but I met him
but
before.
You, right.
So he might.
He like, you shouldn't have read off the phone.
Yeah, you shouldn't have read off the phone, son. You know what I'm saying? I'd be like, dude, you great as fuck. You shouldn't have read off the phone. You
see, and that's.
No way,
shit.
Man.
I'm saying, I mean, like, you know what?
Hey, listen to this. I'm not gonna sit in a cipher with any of y'all and be like, damn, journalist is going in. Hold on.
No, not in a cipher. Not in a cipher.
No,
but if you're on a radio show, a morning radio show or whatever the fuck it is.
No, but
listen.
It was being filmed.
But look,
that's
right. Nobody else would have known.
Okay, but look, let's not forget how we got here, right? We got here because I was talking about my black thought theory of how don't nobody have black thought featured on the song.
But see,
he was like, Royce was the only one that. One of the few, right?
Yeah.
And then I said that, you know, but Meth did cooking, but I see you said like, no, Meth came out the phone, Black came off the dome, and you
Meth,
say it's like it's a dexterity.
But was it
thing.
Off the dome or was it memory?
It's like if they both dive in the pool to go swimming, right? Right, they both might be on steroids, but you wouldn't know if Tariq was on steroids because he's just swimming. But if Meth come with steroids in, he jump in with some flippers on his feet
saying,
for a swimming race.
My flippy flop.
Yeah, Soup saying like the phone is like the flippers.
Right.
How many times are we going to give hip hop a crutch or fucking wheelchair?
It's a wheelchair.
You know what I'm saying? When we come from motherfucking. KRS-One and fucking Rakim and all that shit.
Mm-hmm.
I cannot condone that. I cannot condone a fucking rapper showing up with his fucking notebook and reading out of his fucking notebook.
Yeah. I agree with that.
No, man.
Especially.
And I got love for poets and how they do their shit. You know what I'm saying? And how they do that. This is fucking hip hop. This is rap. Show up and you know that shit,
right.
But don't fucking kick that
but
shit.
That's,
but
mean,
look
no
at the
problem.
Platform for where they.
Now you strong, you ain't been through what I've been through to be this hard. Oh Lord, strike these frauds and right these wrongs through the valley of shadows, staff and rod. If heaven was a whip, they'd probably carjack God. Dog, you can fetch it in, it's not that far. Jesus ain't shitting Nazareth to the world he got. Similar to me walking the park, same passion it costs. I ain't living a lot, y'all just living it false. From here on after y'all prayers gon' cost. Worship,
praying
worship.
For the God in me. Hustle till they run on the speed.
That was produced by my dog Lloyd Bugsy Elders, featuring my homie Alexis Alon, boy Supa Emcee.
Damn.
K Radio, dog.
Damn. Now I'm just gonna keep flowing with this.
One man regime, one Ummah. I follow the scripts of Ibrahim. Like a guillotine, I'll cut the hair from your body. No arm, leg, arm, head, no God body. You wanna know today's mathematics? 12 shoddy. Kick back, chop back, bang, hitting your body. This here's the battle for the heart and the minds. So you best watch your back for you step on the mind. Yeah. This an all-out war to the end of the time. So take caution, I live where it's easy to die. Yeah. Natural flame spinning so it's easy to fry. Any whack motherfucker with the blink of an eye. You're walking out until an all-out horror. So walk light when you're upon us. Let's go.
I am a samurai with the blade. I take off of your head just like the fade. You about to catch a fade just like Knowledge Blade. When you be sitting in the chair, knowledge of fade. See how I rhyme and fade with fade and fade with blade. Cause you getting faded away. I just shot the J. I'm here to shoot the J and then get the chips. You flip it. Get it, no motherfucking casino. Cause you get hit like De Niro or Pacino in the casino. Hey, I still flip it, I never been to Reno. But hey ho, she can suck my dick, I feel like Lego. Oh, it's much better, I can chill and come to a Christmas party in an ugly sweater covered in blood and the butcher knife's in my hand. I just carved up your mans. Yo, that was my fucking plan.
Check it. Now I was born checking in. What's good, everybody?
Oh, my man. Vamp Life, what up? Vamp Life in the house.
Vamp who?
Check. Take your fingers, point up in the sky. I'm the one to blame. No, it's just knowledge born, chilling, spitting flames. You be the first to snatch up your main dame. And I don't really give a damn because these niggas can't maintain.
Fucking drunk off this liquor. You really don't give a fuck and you bitch niggas will never miss you. Niggas is walking around with tight shirt and jeans. Fuck that. Where is hip hop gone? I mean, where is the true lyric to that niggas be spitting? These niggas is constantly in the cypher bullshitting. Swear that they puss like kittens. Stop blowing them to smidgens. Fuck it. What's the next mission?
All right. I gotta turn.